So, welcome back. We're now gonna talk about sustainable use of fresh water. So hopefully you like my little production. Okay, now how can we preserve this precious resource? That's the next topic. That's the next topic for today. Now, water shortages will continue to grow unless we, you and I, and especially big corporations, do something about it. Now, there are different factors that affect water depletion. First of all, the drought and the dry climate that we experience. Aside from that, continuous booming in population will of course affect the usage of water because more people, more water use. And of course, how wasteful people use water will also affect the supply. So the first question is, do you take water for granted? Do you use a cup when you brush your teeth? Yeah, teeth. Now, in any case, well, here, this map right here shows how much stress there is in the amount of rivers in the different areas that we have. So usually water is here being used in human necessity. Now, in this case, the more red an area is, the more that a river cannot support the amount of people living beside it. Now, in this case, we do have current solutions to address the supply of water. However, they may not necessarily be able to solve the problem. Now, usually more groundwater extraction, building larger dams, transferring of water, and then desalination as well. These are some solutions to address the water shortage. But of course, just like any solution, it will have advantages and mostly disadvantages as well. So first we have groundwater extraction. Now let's recall what we discussed in the previous slide. Remember that there are disadvantages as well in the continuous use of groundwater. Because again, it does not replenish easily. Aside from that, we can still build larger dams. However, with building larger dams, we may also build larger problems. So in a way, there should be a balance between the two interests of supplying water for people, and of course, taking care of the environment. Aside from that, we also have water transfers. However, water transfers occur when we try to transfer water from one basin, one source, into another through a series of pumps and pipes. However, this tends to destroy lake ecosystems. Aside from that, it tends to threaten fisheries because we lose bodies of water where we can apply aquaculture or fisheries. Aside from that, this actually hinders a natural flushing action that we have of how the water cycle tends to replenish water basins on a regular basis. And another excessive use of water, again, is how wasteful we are. Well, we don't necessarily have lawns, but in an article by the Scientific American, there is an article where a lot of Americans are actually obsessed with lawns and that this leads to excessive water use. Aside from that, we can also tackle desalination. However, this usually uses reverse osmosis or distillation to remove the salts from the salt water. Therefore, we get fresh water. However, it's a costly process and that oftentimes this disrupts food chain in the marine environment. And then, of course, where do you dump the salt back? Disposing of the salt is also a huge problem as well. Now, this is just a picture of how the processes happen. Remember that when we talk about osmosis, in this case, this is reverse osmosis. So we try to move water from a high concentration to a lower concentration. And aside from that, we try to distill it as well. So we try to get fresh water from salt water. However, of course, the biggest thing that we can still do is that we try to change within ourselves. And of course, we also press bigger companies to use water responsibly, especially the more productive countries. Now, usually we can protect areas that produce and harbor fresh water. As much as possible, we try to promote a cleaner environment. We use a drip irrigation system to minimize water in farming. Of course, conserve water in our own ways. We try to recycle water in households for irrigating our little houseplants. All you garden titas, just like me. Okay, and aside from that, we try to use gray water for flushing. And finally, we try to control population growth as well. Less people, less water use, of course. Now, we may not see the problem now per se, but actually in different areas it's very much visible, especially during the summer, wherein we oftentimes have to line up just to get a bucket of fresh water. We may not experience it because of our privilege, but remember that our countrymen are facing these very real problems. But should we wait until we ourselves experience it? No. We should do actions now so that we can promote the welfare of our countrymen as well. So therefore, that actually ends our lecture. So right now, the next part of our activity is to promote conservation of water and of course live by those codes that we try to impose. So I'll try to discuss how we can do Earth Needs Means, the next activity for this particular module. So I'll see you in the next couple of videos. Bye!